Hello and welcome to CS++. This is the video series where I attempt to make computer science as available and accessible as possible. This video is in the CS101 series, and I do recommend that you watch all of the 101 videos before moving on to 201. Now, this video is about for loops. And for loops come in many different forms depending on the programming language that you're using, and some programming languages even have multiple different forms of for loops. But the idea is basically for value in range, and then whatever work you want to perform. Now, this is overly simplified when it comes to a language like the C family, C, C++, Java, C Sharp, etc. They are more like this. You have the init, then you have a test, then you have an increment. Now, I've been avoiding talking about specific programming languages in these episodes, but I think it's worth pointing out that, again, they have many different ways of creating for loops. But the general idea is that you do something like for x in 1, 3, 5, 7, print x. And the output that you would get from doing something like this would end up being just simply 1, 3, 5, 7, printed. And that's the whole goal of a for loop, really. Of course, it makes more sense in the larger context of a full computer program, but often you just have things that you need to loop over. So for some name in your database engine, send an email to the person with that name, something like that. Again, a very simplistic view, but that is the idea of for loops. Okay, so your homework for today . Think about a list of things that you might process. And, you know, to keep it meta here, it might be something like you might have a bunch of different items of homework that you need to work on, and this was just some way of kind of conceptualizing what this might look like. For each item in homework, do that item. All right, so thanks for watching this episode of CS++. Hope to see you in a future episode.